To get more updates, tips and instructions on how to do registrations, tasks, chores and have fun in Zambia, click on the subscribe button below and subscribe to this channel.
In this video, we will look at 10 things that will be helpful if you are visiting Zambia for the first time. We will look at the general atmosphere in the country, crime levels, climate and weather, languages you use to communicate and how you do daily transactions like booking a cab or hotel. At the end of the video, we will look at interesting tourist attractions and things only found in Zambia. Let's dive right into it. Number 10. General atmosphere. Zambia is a friendly and beautiful country. It has low crime rates, meaning you have close to zero probability of being attacked, hijacked, or kidnapped if you are in residential or business places. If you are visiting Zambia, you are free to move about without being harassed. According to Statista.com, in 2022 crime index showed that Zambia was amongst the six countries in Africa with the least crime rates. No war has been experienced from the time the country got its independence in 1964. According to WordPopulationReview.com, Zambia was rated as one of the 10 safest countries in Africa as of 2022. People are generally very kind, peaceful, and willing to give help and directions if you ask for assistance. Moreover, it's a beautiful country with many national parks and abundant wildlife. You may see animals like the lion, elephant, buffalo, giraffe, hippo, zebra, and many more. The country has many beautiful waterfalls and rivers and has awesome weather and climate. There are also many fun and breathtaking activities and adventures to explore when you visit Zambia. Number 9. Location. Zambia is located in southern Africa. It is a landlocked country, meaning that it is surrounded by other countries and does not have direct access to any ocean. The countries that surround Zambia are Zimbabwe, Botswana, Malawi, Mozambique, Tanzania, Democratic Republic of Congo, Angola, and Namibia. Since it has no seacoast, this means that if you need to visit Zambia, you have to pass through other countries and you travel either by air transport, road transport, or use a train. No ship will take you directly to Zambia. Number 8. Weather. Zambia has a subtropical climate. It experiences three seasons, which are the cool, hot, and rainy seasons. The cool season is experienced between April and July, with June being the coldest. The hot season is experienced from September to November, with October being the hottest month. The rain season is experienced from November to March. To appreciate and get month-to-month weather patterns, watch the video in the description of this video. The hot seasons are not very hot and the cool seasons are not very cold, so you get moderate average weather throughout the year. Number 7. Languages. The official language in Zambia is English. So if you go to the bank, supermarket or hotel, you will be able to communicate in English. The majority of the local people, especially in urban areas, do understand English, so if you speak English, you will be able to communicate effectively almost everywhere in urban areas. There are many other languages used by local people, with the common ones being Nyanja and Bemba in the capital Lusaka. There is also Lozi, Tonga, Karande, Lunda, and Lavali that are widely spoken, and in total, Zambia has 72 languages. To learn a local greeting in these languages, check the video on the description. Number 6. Foods. Zambia has a lot of natural food and delicacies. The staple and most common food is called Nshima. It is prepared from maize or corn powder and it is taken with beef, chicken, fish and cooked vegetables. Your visit to Zambia is incomplete if you have not taken Nshima. It is very tasty and gives good energy. Majority of Zambians eat this delicacy at least once every day. There are many fast foods and restaurants with a variety of dishes. Many people also enjoy fries and fried chicken, with a fast foods restaurant called Hungry Lion being the best spot for most locals. Well, now let's talk about get around and doing things. Number 5. How to book a taxi. Zambia does not have Uber as of 2023, but has good online taxi apps that will do a good job. As of 2023, the most popular taxi apps in Zambia are Yango and Ulendo. You can book a taxi in the capital city Lusaka and Kitwe using these apps. To see how you can do this, check the video on the description of this video. You can still book an ordinary taxi offline from taxis that are usually parked in busy places like airports, hotels, malls, and so on. Number 4. Accommodation and booking hotels. There are many hotels and you can actually make a booking online using websites like booking.com, expedia.com, and so on. Many hotels do not need a pre-booking, but you do well to check the availability and prices beforehand, especially on busy dates like holidays and festive seasons. There are many fully serviced apartments, especially in the capital Lusaka and the tourist capital Livingstone. There are also lodges and guest houses that are usually a bit cheaper than hotels but also offer good accommodation. Whatever the case, if you are visiting Zambia, you are assured to find clean, affordable, and secure accommodation. Number 3. Currency and making payments. Zambia's currency is called kwacha. As of 2023, the kwacha's rate varies between 16 and 20 kwacha compared to $1. You can exchange dollar to kwacha in banks and bureaus that are readily available at airports and other public places. You can use Visa cards to make payments in hotels and supermarkets. But for most taxis, they will usually accept only cash. And just for your information, if you love Coca-Cola, on average $1 will get you a bottle of 500 ml Coke in Zambia. Number 2. The capitals of Zambia. The capital city of Zambia is Lusaka. It is the most modern, busy, and populous city in Zambia. It is the business hub of the country and most businesses have their headquarters located here. If you plan to drive your vehicle in Lusaka, check the video on the description to see how you can do that. Livingstone is called the tourist capital of Zambia. This is the city that attracts most tourists. Because this is where one of the seven wonders of the world, the Victoria Falls, is located. If you are visiting Zambia, make sure you visit Livingstone. Number 1. Tourist attractions in Zambia. Biggest curtain of falling water. The Victoria Falls, locally known as Mosiowetunya Falls, has been billed as the greatest falling curtain of water on this planet. Of course, it is not the widest waterfall or the highest waterfall in the world. But with all dimensions taken into account, it is considered to be the biggest curtain of falling water in the world, surpassing the magnificent Niagara Falls and Iguazu Falls. Apart from the Victoria Falls, Zambia could be named to be a land of the waterfalls because it has 72 beautiful waterfalls altogether. World largest man-made lake. Lake Kariba is the largest man-made lake in the world, with a maximum length of 223 kilometers and maximum width of 40 kilometers. Construction on Lake Kariba began in the early 1950s out of the necessity to generate hydroelectric energy for Zambia and Zimbabwe. Up to this day, the Kariba Dam provides a source of power for both Zambia and Zimbabwe. Lake Kariba is still the biggest man-made lake in the world. World's largest mammal migration. Every year, up to 10 million African bats migrate to Kasenga National Park. These are giant fruit bats, also known as flying foxes, with straw-colored bodies the size of puppies and wings that span almost 1 meter. Kasenga National Park is located in Chitambo District of Zambia's Central Province. World's largest concentration of hippos. The Luangwa River in Zambia is one of the biggest unaltered rivers in southern Africa and supports Africa's largest population of hippos. Along this stretch of river, there is an official hippo count of 48 animals per kilometer, the largest concentration of hippopotamus in the world. World's largest emerald mine. Kajum Mine is believed to be the world's largest emerald-producing mine. Located in the southern part of Zambia's Copper Belt province. This open-pit mine lies in the center of mineral-rich province called Ndola Rural Emerald Restricted Area. Today, the mine supplies about 1 in 4 of the world's emeralds. the largest emerald in the world was actually discovered on this mine in Zambia. It weighed an amazing 1.5 kg and was named Chipembele. Did you find this information helpful? Hope you did.